arrival for NFL primetime. If you only knew. Chris Berman along with Booger McFarland. And ladies and gentlemen, if this is October football,
yes.
My goodness, how many plays of seemingly 75 yards or more that were just wow.
It's amazing. As the season has gone on, the games and the plays start to get a little bit better, Boom.
You know, if we sit down like 10 minutes into the fourth quarter of all these games, yeah. Which we watch, you can't leave.
No.
Now, heaven forbid if there's overtime. Now, look, we had a team trying to stay undefeated. Kansas City doesn't play to Monday night. As we speak, the Chiefs are 4-0. Minnesota trying to get to 5-0. We'll get to them in a minute. If the Chiefs don't make the Super Bowl in the AFC, well, in August, there are four teams we're going to get right to. Houston and Buffalo, who are 3-1 each. And Baltimore and Cincinnati, who started 0-2 and 1-3, respectively. Mm. So a little more urgency on that one. Why don't we start with that?
Let's do it.
AFC contenders, or at least certainly was before the season started. Lamar Jackson, the Bengals, 41-38. And you see the numbers. Lamar threw four touchdowns. Joe Burrow threw five. Henry rushed for almost 100, but that's not the career story. Derrick Henry is kind of the end of an era in a lot of ways. He's the 27th player in NFL history, they've been playing since 1920, with 100 total touchdowns. And he's the 32nd player. He passed the 10,000-yard mark in this game. And we will say this, of the 31 others that are at 10,000 yards, 16 are in the Hall of Fame. Kimberly Martin with Zay Flowers exhausted after the game.
Your quarterback kept you guys coming back. What can you say about Lamar Jackson?
That's why he MVP. That's why he one of the best in the league, because what he do, he can use his feet, he can kill you with his arm, and we got Big 2-2 in the back. So
I was going to say, hey. What was going through your mind?
Oh, I knew every time he touched it, I'm thinking touchdown. Like, he tell me in the locker room every day, I'm a home run hitter. I only need, like, 15 carries, because he keeps saying he's a home run hitter, and he keep proving it every week. So, yeah, 2-2.
We're 1-4. That's not where we want to be. So obviously something has to change. You know, I'm not sure what that is on our end. We'll do some critical thinking, watch the tape, and see where we could have done better. There's plenty to improve on. That's no secret.
You won 59 yards, and Fairburn saves the day for the Texans. Another wild game. And so the Buffalo Bills have now lost two in a row. They got shellacked at Baltimore, as we all saw last week. And then Houston has won it, and they are now 4-1. Sean McDermott on the decisions late.
Tough game. I thought our guys did a great job coming back. Coaches made good adjustments. Just not enough in the end. And that's on me. The end of game situation on offense. We needed two. We're in a tough situation. Three timeouts. They're holding three timeouts. I got a good field goal kicker. We needed to run the clock and move the chains and. And that's on me. We didn't do that there, and that's my fault.
John, were you on board with the three passes?
I'm not going to get into that. I don't think that's relevant right now, Sal. Overall, again, that's on me. So we just got to do a better job. I got to do a better job in that situation.
So the Bills have started out so impressively. Let's start with them. We'll get to Houston here quickly. We'll never know. Had Houston had one or two timeouts left, maybe they would have run it at worst to get maybe 7 yards for the punter more room at worst. The end was a head scratcher.
It was a big head scratcher, Boom, on a day where Josh Allen completed only 9 passes, where your defense kept you in the ball game in the second half, you got 2 turnovers, and you get in that situation. Houston's got 3 timeouts. You can't throw the football 3 straight plays. You got to say, you know what? The likelihood of us driving 90-something yards is very unlikely. So I need to run the football, make them use timeouts, burn some clock. Instead, he didn't do that. 3 straight passes. Now Houston gets the ball back, and they have all their timeouts. So they can set up for a game-winning field goal. Sean McDermott has come under fire for his clock management for a long time. And here's another situation where we're going to question his clock management because he cost his team an opportunity to at least go to overtime.
No, the defense shackled it up in the second half after a while, but that was a befuddling. So give Houston defense credit. And look, this is the best game Houston's played. It's the toughest test they've had. I mean, I understand they Minnesota's undefeated, so I don't mean to say, well, they skunked
Correct.
Houston. But at the time, we didn't think. How do you think they are after 5 weeks? They've come through in the clutch the last 2 weeks for sure.
They're playing better, but they're putting too much on their quarterback.
Okay.
C.J. Stroud is having to save them. Joe Mixon, they miss him. They got no running game. So in the end, it's, hey, C.J., save us. He did it last week.
Yep.
He did it this week with some help from Sean McDermott. But in the future, if they're going to achieve their goals, which is getting deep into the AFC playoffs, they got to get a running game. Joe Mixon coming back may help, but they got to get more. It can't just be the C.J. Stroud show and nobody else, because the last 2 weeks, that's what it's been.
No, but you know what? It's not like, uh-oh, expectations aren't too big for us, at least not here in early October.
Not yet. Yeah,
they don't
exactly.
have to apologize for them when nobody else in the division is over 500. 9 touchdown passes, Burrow and Lamar Jackson in an amazing game. Baltimore's 3-2, but the Bengals are 1-4. These two quarterbacks put on a show, but for Burrow, where are we sitting at 1-4?
You know,
not good.
We keep talking about the Bengals, and they say, well, it's early. We always do this. Yeah, it's early. Well, you know what? It's getting late early. They're 1-4, and I'm going to give them that's a 3-count, boom. And in wrestling,
Uh-oh.
That means you're out. I think they've reached a situation where they cannot come back from. And if you're looking at the head coach and Zach Taylor, when you get the turnover, you got an opportunity to go and win the game. Don't test the football guys. Don't just run it 3 times and set up for a field goal. Actually try
right.
to win the game. And he didn't do that. So we got questionable coaching situations, one from Buffalo and Sean McDermott. And in our second game, Zach Taylor, they're going to – late at night, they're going to think about those situations because they could have played the game differently. And I think the outcome may have been differently for their teams.
Baltimore, pass defense. Of course, Humphrey made a good – but again, they've won 3 in a row and gotten off the mat at 0-2. There's the difference.
If the defense just gets close to what they were, boom, Lamar Jackson is playing outstanding. They lead the league in rushing by a long ways. Derrick Henry is what the doctor ordered. But the defense, to your point, the defense has got to come a little bit more. I love the play.
Usually late. Does.
Can
I'm looking for no man.